Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja. Today I want to talk to you about the differences between a P100 filter and an N95 filter for your respirator or mask that you're trying to use for your either mold remediation, fiberglass removal of insulation, either in a crawl space or a basement or an attic. So stay tuned. Okay, so before I get started, I wanted to show you something. This is Dustin and his wife down in Columbus, Georgia. This is one of our three franchisees, and they got a cool write-up on one of the magazines there, and we're going to make this available on franchise.crawlspaceninja.com. But Dustin, just wanted to say congrats, man. There's his team up there, his ninjas that are working with him, and they are doing fantastic. Even with the social distancing and things like that, we've all had things to overcome, but Dustin and his team are doing great. So just wanted to say congratulations. And I had this framed up for you, Dustin. I'm going to be sending this to you. Nice little pretty frame I had made. Actually, my wife had it made. It's actually a metal frame, so it ought to be cool. So you can hang it up and show it to your girls as they grow up. So congratulations there, Dustin. Just wanted to say great job. And also wanted to remind everybody about our giveaway. We're still, this is for our April giveaway, April 2020. We're giving away the ThermPro indoor-outdoor humidity monitor. But guess what? In May, next month, April Air has decided to help us with our giveaway. And you need to make sure you're watching all of the videos in May. Because Brian, I don't know if you remember Brian, but we've done a lot of videos with Brian. If you want to check out some of those, just type in April Air Crawl Space Ninja on YouTube and you should be able to find the videos that Brian and I did together. But he has authorized us to give away an April Air 1820 dehumidifier at the end of May. So all the videos in May, you're going to get a chance to register to win that. And of course, you register by subscribing to our YouTube channel and then either answering or making a comment in the space down below so that we can get you registered. So stay tuned for that. So thankful to Brian and April Air for helping us with our giveaway next month. But for now, let's get started. So first of all, this is a respirator. All right, so this isn't necessarily what I'm talking about. This is a 3M. Typically, we use the 6000 series full-face respirator. Couple of things about respirators, all right? Whether you're looking at putting on a surgical mask or a respirator. I'm not talking about surgical masks. I'm not talking about those things. I'm talking about respirators. For someone like me who's a beardy, okay, so I'm gonna have a hard time getting a good seal with this respirator. As you can see, there's a beardy. That's my son's beardy. I'm not talking about that kind of beardy. I'm talking about me and those of you out there that have facial hair. Okay, there are some, if you keep your facial hair in this area, it's not that big of a deal, but if you've got facial hair all around here, you're not gonna get a good seal with this mask and it's gonna be ineffective. So if you're working in the crawl space, make sure you chop that hair off, that beard or a mustache that's growing out around that so you can get a good seal, because the filter only works as well as the seal of the mask, okay? Typically, this is a medium. For the most part, mediums are gonna fit most people out there, but if you got a big head like I do, all right, you may wanna go with a large, all right? So unfortunately, because of everything that's going on in the world today, we are having a hard time getting these, but I'm gonna put a link down below to our category, so that way you can, if you need a respirator, you can check back with us and see if we've got these available. But these are our full face. Couple thing about the full face, I would recommend you get these plastic covers, especially if you're using this for a job. Now, if it's a one-time deal, you're going to use this and maybe not ever use it again. Maybe you don't need these, but these covers really do a great job of protecting the face part of the respirator. Also, if you wear glasses, you're probably not going to be able to use this respirator with your glasses, okay? So another thing, one last tip about this respirator or any respirator is you want to make sure you protect it. This is UV sensitive. So it typically comes with a UV bag. I'm not sure if this model does or not. I believe it does, but in case it does not, make sure you put your respirators, even the half face respirators, in some kind of protective bag or something like that. Don't put them up on the dash of the vehicle or things like that, because it can really over time damage these respirators. So let's get into what the topic is actually about, which is, what's the difference between a P100 mask and an N95 mask? All right, just so you know, there's actually three types. There's a P, an N, and an R. Okay, so an N means no oil. You can't use any kind of oil or anything like that. It's not designed to be around any kind of oil. And I would even say aerosols, okay? So I'm not really a big fan of using an N mask if you're gonna be aerosol, or maybe you're applying paints or things like that, anything that's oil-based. R means that it can be exposed to some oils. And then P means it's okay around oils, okay? So that's the letters, P100, N95, and then R. I've never used an R mask. I don't even know if you can get them. I'm sure you can because they make them, but it's not something that we typically come across. Most people are familiar with the N95. That's gets most of the publicity, and then the P100. Okay, so you got P, that's good for using with oils, and N, no oils, okay? Then you got 100 on the P's and 95 on the N's. Now, 95 means that it'll capture up to 95% of what's in the air. Now, remember, I'm not talking about oils or even liquids for that matter. Now, it may be okay for liquids, but I'm going to say it's not good to use with any kind of liquids, because most liquids have some kind of oil in it. So N95 is more for your dust mask. If you're a wood shop person, or maybe you're yanking insulation out or something like that, that's okay. But if you're going to do any kind of fogging or applying X70 or applying cleaner or Anabec products or anything like that, I would rather you go for the P. The 100 is actually a better capture rate. It captures 99.97, according to NIOSH, of the particulate that it's rated for. So in the event that you're looking to do mold remediation where you're using aerosols or things like that, I would recommend you go with the P100. Another thing about any kind of respirator, whether it's the pancake or the cartridge kind, make sure that if you're not using it, you store it in a bag. Okay, again, if this is exposed to air movement or things like that, or dust settles on it, let's say again, you throw it up in the dash of the car, you roll your windows down, and pollen and all that stuff is flying around in the car, it can hamper the use of the mask, all right? So you wanna make sure that you're keeping these things in a sealed bag whenever you're not using them. And it doesn't matter if it's an N95 or a P100. The cartridges, the same way. You wanna make sure you put them in a protective case when not being used. From what I've read, you're gonna get about 40 hours of straight use out of a P100 mask. They say they last about 6 months, but now if you're not using them every day, yes, you may be able to get 6 months out of them, but if you're in nasty crawl spaces like we are, I would maybe consider changing them out more often than 40 hours, but certainly keep a track on that. But anyway, so that's some of the differences between the P100 and the N95 masks. And let's talk about our question this month so that you can get registered for our drawing. Okay, so instead of a question this month for our drawing, what I want to do is ask, what is your profession that you would need a respirator? Okay, so if you're not in a profession that needs a respirator, just let me know down in the comments what you have used respirators for in the past, whether it's DIY projects around the house or whatever. So that way you can give us an idea of who's watching our videos, right? If you're working in the Navy, for example, when I was in the Navy, we had to have respirators and do all kinds of things. Or maybe you're in mold remediation or water damage restoration. Be sure to comment below what you're using your respirators for so that we can get you entered into our drawing. And make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And my name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja. And we hope you make it a happy and blessed day. We'll see you later.